Hi, I am Dr. Sudhir, Assistant Professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering of Government Engineering College, Bharatpur. Today, in this lecture, we are going to describe the concept of the continuous wave modulation, type of the modulation, primary, what are the basic primary resources of the communication system, and what is the purpose of communication system, and why modulation is required for transmitting a signal from one place to another place. So before giving an idea about the continuous wave modulation, first I want to describe the introduction of continuous wave modulation. Basically, the purpose of continuous wave modulation is to transmit information bearing signal or baseband signal through a communication channel separating the transmitter from the receiver. The term baseband is used to design the band of frequencies representing the original signal as delivered by a source of information. The proper utilization of communication channel requires a shift of range or baseband frequency into other frequency range suitable for the transmission, and the corresponding shift back to the original frequency range after reception. For example, a shift of range of frequencies in a signal is accomplished by a carrier is called modulation, which is defined as the process by which some characteristics of a carrier is varied in accordance with the message or modulating signal. We can say baseband signal is referred as modulating wave, and as the result of the modulation process is referred to as modulated wave. Modulation is performed at the transmitting end of the communication system. At the receiver end of the system, we usually require original baseband signal to the restore. This is accomplished by using a process known as demodulation process. So basically, modulation process is performed at the transmitter side, and demodulation process is performed in the receiver side. In this lecture, we study two widely named family of the continuous wave modulation scheme, namely amplitude modulation and angle modulation. In amplitude modulation, the amplitude of the sinusoidal carrier wave is varied in according to the baseband signal. On the other hand, in angle modulation, the angle of sinusoidal carrier wave is varied in accordance with the baseband signal. Particular, now we are going to describe what are the communication and what are the basic essential component of the communication. So particular in this lecture, we are describing the main feature of the communication system. First important part of the communication system is information source. The information source is able to deliver any type of the signal or any type of the message signal. We can say message signal can be referred as the modulating signal, baseband signal. We can also say modulating signal. So modulating signal is applied to the transmitter for the transmitting of the signal. Then after that, the transmitter transmit the modified signal into a form which is suitable for transmission over the channel, which is achieved by the modulation. So basically, modulation is the process in which we shift the frequency range of the modulating signal, which is suitable for the transmission between transmitted to the receiver. Now, what are the modulation techniques? Means first to describe the modulation technique, first we describe what is the modulation process. Basically, modulation is defined as transmitting the message signal through phase space. It is the process of transmission of information signal into using a high frequency carrier signal. So now question is that why modulation is required? So one of these are the following regions on which modulation is required. First is that carrying one signal to another signal means use carrier as a carrier which carry one signal from one place to another place, and the second modulated signal is transmitted. So here the transmitter transmits the modulated signal. So here we require the modulation process. And some after generating the modulated signal, now it is required to transmit this modulated signal into the free space with the help of the antenna. So these are the antenna specifications from which any modulated signal can be transmitted from one place to another place. So basically modulation process is characterized by this definition, the process by which some characteristics of a signal call carrier varied in accordance with the instantaneous value of another signal called modulating signal. Information bearing signal is called modulating signal. The signal before modulation is called modulating signal, and the signal after modulation is called modulated signal. So the signal resulting from process of modulation is known as the modulated signal. Now we are going to describe what are the types of the modulation. Basically, modulation process can be characterized into the two main categories. One category is continuous wave modulation. In this modulation, we use carrier as a continuous form. And the second type of the modulation is called pulse modulation. In pulse modulation, we use carrier as a form of the pulse. Now, in particular, sine wave carrier, we describe three types of the modulation process. First, amplitude modulation, second, frequency modulation, and third, phase modulation. So in particular amplitude modulation, we define the process in which amplitude of the carrier is changed according to the instantaneous value of the modulating signal. Suppose here signal is defined as Vc cos 2 pi fct plus phi, where fc is the carrier frequency and phi is the initial phase which is generated by the carrier. After that, here we are showing the waveform of the amplitude modulation. First waveform is shown as a modulating signal, and the second waveform is shown as a modulated signal. Means the signal after modulation is called modulated signal, and the signal before modulating signal is called modulating signal. So modulated signal in form of amplitude modulation is defined as Vc cos 2 pi fct 1 plus m cos 2 pi fmt, where Vc is unmodulated peak carrier amplitude, Fc is the carrier frequency, Fm is the modulation frequency, and M is the modulation index. Means here we are represented as the degree of the modulation, which value is lie between 0 to 1. And if M is greater than 1, then in that case modulation become over modulation. So in case of over modulation condition, the envelope of the modulated signal is not same as the envelope of the message signal. Showing the waveform of modulated signal with different modulated index. Suppose one first signal is represented as the modulating signal, we can say baseband signal, we can say information bearing signal, and the second waveform is shown that in case of when index value is zero. So in this case that is called unmodulated carrier. If index is increased and that is equal to m is equal to 0.5, then in that case modulated carrier is shown like this. So we are increasing the modulation index step by step. Now after modulation, it is very important to discuss about the what are the amplitude spectrum, what are the frequency spectrum. So basically signal can be represented into the two mainly domain, time domain representation as well as frequency domain representation. So in particular, if in first case we are going to describe the representation of the amplitude signal in time domain representation. First waveform is shown that carrier, and in middle waveform is shown that is modulated signal, and the third waveform is shown carrier modulated with a range of the frequencies. Now we are going to describe the what are the frequency spectrum component in amplitude modulation. So before describing the side bands which are generated in amplitude modulation, we want to discuss about the what are the side bands. Basically side bands are the frequency band. So frequency band, it is defined as the band of frequencies in which signal are lies. So we can say the frequencies of AM signal is called the frequency component of AM signal is lie in that particular band, efficiency of AM signal. So before describing the efficiency, we want to describe the total power which is transmitted by the antenna, which is defined as PT is equal to PC 1 plus M square upon 2, where PT is the total transmitted power which is transmitted by the antenna, and PC is the carrier power transmitted by that antenna, and M is the modulation index of the AM modulator. Here we are describing the virtue, limitation and modification of amplitude modulation. Basically amplitude modulation is wasteful of the power because carrier wave is completely independent of the information bearing signal or baseband signal MT. The information of carrier wave therefore represent a waste of the power, which means in amplitude modulation only a fraction of total transmitted power is actually affected by MT. So, and the second limitation of AM wave is amplitude modulation is wasteful of bandwidth, because upper and lower side band of AM wave are uniquely related to each other by virtue of their symmetry about carrier frequency. Hence, given the amplitude and phase spectra of either side band, we can uniquely determine the other. This means that the transmission of information is concerned, only one sideband is necessary, and communication channel therefore need to provide only same bandwidth as the baseband signal. In light of this